What can meditation and some of its fundamental aspects in terms of mindfulness, how can that help or affect our daily life? John Kabat-Zinn for many, many years has been trying to see how bringing more mindfulness in our way of being can help people who are sick, physically, mentally. So he's going to explain his work on mindfulness-based meditation.
Thank you, Mathieu, and Your Holiness. I would like to speak with you this morning about work that my colleagues and I have been doing for the past 26 years now at the University of Massachusetts Medical School. Many of those colleagues are here in the audience, and in fact, there are many people here in the audience who have been doing this kind of work now, as I will show you later. And really, the essence of it is to see as an experiment whether we could not, to the degree of our own understanding, take the essence of Buddhist meditation practice and in some way make it accessible to people who would not find it through a traditional Buddhist or spiritual path, but who nevertheless were plagued by suffering and dukkha. And as you yourself so often point out, suffering is a universal phenomenon. All of our minds are basically the same. All of our bodies are basically the same. And so potentially the Buddha Dharma, if there was some way to translate it so that it would not lose its essential dimensions, but become available to be heard and enacted or embodied by other people, might be valuable. So that was the challenge, if you will, the experiment. And we've now been doing it for 26 years. So stress reduction becomes an incredibly important and potentially interesting vehicle for helping people to reestablish balance and well-being in their lives as a complement to whatever the doctors are able to do for people. So since we call what we do mindfulness-based stress reduction, I think it's fair to ask, what is mindfulness? And I really don't need to say much about it after Ajahn Amaro's gorgeous presentation and embodiment of it. It's spoken of often as the heart of Buddhist meditation. We speak of mindfulness. So we define it as moment-to-moment non-judgmental awareness that's cultivated by paying attention on purpose in the present moment. So I'm going to very briefly try to sketch out the MBSR program because it's been written about a great deal. I don't need to go into great detail. But what we're trying to do is create an environment where people can learn to slow down in their lives and maybe even stop and familiarize themselves with stilling the body and observing what's going on in both body and mind. Cultivating a certain kind of intimacy with the present moment as it is. Now, most of the time, people are very surprised to discover, when they start to pay attention in this way, that they don't live in the present moment. They live mostly in the future, worrying or planning, all of us are that way, or in the past, remembering things that have happened before and sometimes getting quite bent out of shape about it. So stopping, in some sense, in Western society is a very radical act. Just stopping and then opening one's field of awareness. Ultimately, I believe it's an act of self-compassion. So it's, in some sense, the discovery of the capacity for awareness and wakefulness in one's life.